हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू डीप ब्रेन लिंक। वी आर एडटेक स्टार्टअप हेल्पिंग यू लर्न योर ड्रीम टेक्नोलॉजीज फास्टर एंड बेटर। जॉइन आवर डिस्कॉर्ड ग्रुप फॉर मोर इन्फॉर्मेशन। दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द फर्स्ट ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ द DSA सीरीज। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट व्हाई डू वी नीड एल्गोरिदम्स एंड व्हाट आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ लर्निंग। सो व्हाट इज एन एल्गोरिदम? एन एल्गोरिदम इज अ प्रोसेस टू सॉल्व अ गिवन प्रॉब्लम। For example, we want to solve a given jumbled array. How will you sort it? You will use a sorting algorithm, right? So algorithm basically run the world. They are the backbone of actual computer science. It is basically a set of instructions which allows you to do your work more efficiently and fast. The most basic example of an algorithm can be sorting. So, if let's write a code to sort a given jumbled array. The data type will obviously be an integer, and I am going to name my array as ARR, and I'm going to hard code the value of the array as 5. Then I'm going to pass in some jumbled integers or values, let's say 5, 4, 6, 7, 1, and make sure it does not exceed this hard coded value, the number of indices here. Then we are going to use a sort keyword. Sort comes from the STL library, that is this standard template library from C++, and the syntax will be the sort keyword, and in bracket we are going to write the name of the array and ARR. In the second parameter we are going to pass ARR plus 5, and if you remember 10th class AP, that is arithmetic progression, we will write ARR plus N, and N as in the last value of our array. After that we are going to print the sorted array. For that we are going to use a for loop, and I will be less than 5, of course. I++ cout and the value, the name of a variable, and in a square bracket we are going to write I because it's under the for loop. Now we are going to compile and run our program to see if it actually works. And it does. Our array was 5, 4, 6, 7, 1, and the sorted array that we get is 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you just used an algorithm, that is the sorting method, to sort our given array. And in the upcoming tutorials we are going to learn about more such algorithms that will help you in the time complexities of your code as well. And if you get intimidated or overwhelmed, don't be, because we'll be guiding you from the basics to advanced. Thanks for watching.